"And no doubt she will, Mrs. Dr. dear," said Susan, after Miss Cornelia had gone. "She would stick at nothing, not even at shingling the church spire, if she took it into her head. But I cannot understand how even Cornelia Bryant can talk to a minister as she does. You would think he was just any common person." When Miss Cornelia had gone, Nan Blythe uncurled herself from the hammock where she had been studying her lessons and slipped away to Rainbow Valley. The others were already there. Jem and Jerry were playing quoits with old horseshoes borrowed from the Glen blacksmith. Carl was stalking ants on a sunny hillock. Walter, lying on his stomach among the fern, was reading aloud to Mary and Di and Faith and Una from a wonderful book of myths wherein were fascinating accounts of Prester John and the Wandering Jew, divining rods and tailed men, of Shamir, the worm that split rocks and opened the way to golden treasure, of Fortunate Isles and Swan Maidens. It was a great shock to Walter to learn that William Tell and Gellert were myths also, and the story of Bishop Hatto was to keep him awake all that night. But best of all, he loved the stories of the Pied Piper and the Sangreal. He read them thrillingly, while the bells on the tree lovers tinkled in the summer wind and the coolness of the evening shadows crept across the valley. "Say, ain't them interestin' lies," said Mary admiringly when Walter had closed the book.
"They aren't lies," said Di indignantly.
"You don't mean they're true?" asked Mary incredulously.
"No, not exactly. They're like those ghost stories of yours. They weren't true, but you didn't expect us to believe them, so they weren't lies."
"That yarn about the divining rod is no lie anyhow," said Mary. "Old Jake Crawford over harbor can work it. They send for him everywhere they want to dig a well. And I believe I know the Wandering Jew."
"Oh, Mary," said Una, awestruck.
"I do, true's you're alive. There was an old man at Mrs. Wiley's one day last fall. He looked old enough to be anything. She was asking him about cedar posts, if he thought they'd last well. And he said, 'Last well? They'll last 1,000 years. I know, for I've tried 'em twice.' Now, if he was 2,000 years old, who was he but your Wandering Jew?"
"I don't believe the Wandering Jew would associate with a person like Mrs. Wiley," said Faith decidedly.